Hey everybody, it's Jack from The Modern Coder, and today I'm going to explain how to solve merge conflicts that come up when using Git Cherry Pick. And now there are two main types of merge conflicts that typically come up when you're using Cherry Pick, and I'll explain both of those. As always, I'll be using live animations of what's happening under the hood while I'm issuing these commands, and you'll find those animations pop up right above my head in this video. Now, I promise these animations really help, and I'm confident by the end of this video, you will not only understand how to fix any merge conflicts you come across, but you'll be able to tackle them without any fear. All right, let's not waste any time. Let's jump right into it. Here's what my repository looks like at the moment. That white branch is mainline, and then you can see my coworker split off onto that blue branch to work on some navigational components. But as you can see, they've also fixed a bug before they started working on that nav component. And let's say I want to take just that bug fix and pull it over into mainline without taking any of their other in-progress changes. This is what Cherry Pick is really good for. So if I were to start that Cherry Pick process by going ahead and grabbing the commit hash of the bug fix and attempting to cherry pick, you're going to see that I have a problem. I have a merge conflict. Well, how do you know what failed? Well, the failure message on the screen doesn't tell us that much. So let's clear the screen and run git status to get a bit more information. Okay, this is much better. What this is telling us is that we are currently on main. We're also currently in the process of picking this specific commit. And it also gives us a little cheat sheet about how to proceed in the case that we need a reminder of what our options are from here. Now, lastly, it tells us which files it had trouble merging, and now it's the key part. As you can see here, it tells us that both the bug fix commit and the latest commit on main modified config.yaml, and it couldn't merge it automatically. Now, if I pull up our Git tree and zoom in a little bit on these commits, you can see that the bug fix commit actually fixed a bug in config.yaml file. However, since splitting off, main has also gotten a new commit that modified config.yaml as well, and that's why there's a merge conflict. Okay, let's fix it. So first off, if you realize you've gotten way in over your head and you just want to kind of eject from the situation and you don't want to do the cherry pick anymore, you can always type git cherry pick abort like this. And with that, git will cancel your cherry pick and set everything back to normal. Okay, let's just roll it back and say we do actually want to continue to fix this conflict. Well, we need to open up the file that has the conflict and manually fix it. In this case, the file is config.yaml, and so I'll just open it for editing in Vi. And I'm just using Vim because it's available on most terminal systems, but you can use any text editor that you want, whether you use Sublime, VS Code, JetBrains, whatever. You wanna look for these weird looking lines with the less than and greater than characters. This is the specific spot in the file that Git couldn't merge automatically. Now, as you can see, that top section indicates what that part of the file looks like on main, and below that, you can see what that part of the file looks like on the bug fix branch. Now, your goal is to manually replace this entire block with what those lines should look like after the merge. There may be one or more of these blocks. All right, so as you can see here, that show drafts moving from true to false is the bug fix, so I wanna keep that. So I'll just press I in Vim to enter edit mode and change that to false. And then on mainline, looks like the new changes are the addition of the social media handles, so we can keep those. And then if I go ahead and delete the rest of the lines that we don't need, this is what the file should look like after the merge. And that's it, you can make any changes you want. But for now, that's all I need. And so for Vim, the command to exit and save the file is escape colon WQ. So I'm going to go ahead and enter that. Now I'm pop back out onto my main terminal. Now that we've made that merge manually, we can go ahead and stage that file by using git add. And we can go ahead and verify that by typing git status again. And you can see it turns green that they're waiting to be committed. And now from here, it's really easy. All we have to do is type git cherry pick continue for it to continue the cherry picking operation. Now, one last thing before we're done, git is going to kick us into our terminal's default text editor to specify a commit message. And this is good practice to give descriptive names to our commits, especially if they were cherry picked. So it ported over the original commit message here. So bug fix and config, I'll change that to also added socials. And then we're going to make sure to let it know that this was cherry picked from this particular commit. So all I'm gonna do is save it. And again, it's escape colon WQ if you're using Vim. Hit enter, and that's it. Now, if I clear the screen and run git log one line, you can see that I end up with that cherry picked commit right on top that includes our merge. Now, I promise there were two types of merge conflicts that you could potentially run across with cherry pick. And the second type of conflict is gonna happen when those files on main aren't committed yet. So in other words, they're just your local changes. Now, if that's the case, when you run git cherry pick, you're gonna end up with a message like this, slightly different than the last message that we saw. What git is gonna tell you here is that you have local changes that conflict with the cherry pick that you're trying to do, and it's just going to abort altogether. Now you can either commit those changes into a commit on main and go through that same workflow we just talked about. Now you could just also set aside those local changes using git stash and sort of push them to the side and then continue with your cherry pick as you did before. And that's gonna work, but when you go to pull those changes out of your stash, you're gonna get a merge conflict that you have to solve. So either way, you're on a collision course with merge. Now I'll have a video out about git stashing shortly because the workflow is pretty cool, but if you wanna use it now, fixing a git stash apply merge conflict is very similar to what you just learned in this video, so I'm sure you could figure it out. Now, if you wanna learn more and other git techniques with this same sort of video animation type style, I have a whole playlist and multiple other videos about that. Subscribe if you want more git videos, and then let me know in the comments if there's anything else you'd like me to cover in this way. Other than that, I think that's all I got for now. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later.